We can all agree that humanity has come a long way over the last few centuries. Some discoveries were made far beyond our little planet. Men have walked on the moon, or did they? We'll leave that topic for another video. There are still some areas on Earth that humans have never laid eyes on. The lesser you know about these destinations, the more you crave for it. But some places are either too dangerous, too protected, or too mysterious to explore. Maybe the curious people would get a thrill from visiting some of these strange and dangerous places. But for most of us, reading about it is quite enough. So, let's look at a list of the most forbidden places you're not allowed to visit. Number 10. The Mariana Trench. This trench is probably the deepest place we know on Earth. It's underwater, as are many other unexplored areas. There has been a lot of speculation on what lives inside this place, but only xenophyophores, that's a type of starfish that lives at the bottom of the ocean, are confirmed so far. These are a mere single-cell entity that use water minerals to build their exoskeletons. The most recent measurement of its depth revealed a result of around 36,070 feet. If we were to place Mount Everest, the highest peak in the world, into this trench, the mountain would be submerged. Its topmost peak would actually be a mile below the surface. The theories of a humongous sea monster living there would surely perk you up. Some people have even theorized that the monsters living in the Mariana Trench will one day rise up and attack us. If and when that day comes, we may have to fight for our territory with equally huge robots. For now, though, this trench is a U.S. National Monument. Then U.S. President George W. Bush made it so back in 2009. Before we move on, I've got a little challenge for you that'll take 5 seconds to complete. So here's the deal. You just leave a like on this video, smash that subscribe button, and hit the notification bell, and you'll get 25 years of amazing luck. Try it. It really works. Number 9. Siberian Sakha Republic. The Siberian Sakha Republic covers about 20% of Russia. Much of it is above the Arctic Circle. It's a place not known for being very human-friendly because the average temperature is somewhere between negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit and freezing. The Siberian Sakha Republic is roughly the size of the entire country of India. Comprising half the Far Eastern Federal District, it is the largest subnational governing body by area in the world, at 1,190,555 square miles. Its capital is the city of Yakutsk, and it's known for its extreme and severe climate, with the lowest temperatures in the northern hemisphere being recorded below minus 35 degrees Celsius on average in the winter. Migrating from the area around Lake Baikal, the Turkic Sakha people first settled the Middle Lena sometime between the 9th and 16th centuries, likely in several waves, bringing the pastoral economy of Central Asia with them. The Soviet period saw the migration of many ethnic Russians and Ukrainians into the area. The modern Republic of Sakha was established in 1991 following the dissolution of the Soviet Union. Number 8. Lascaux Caves, France. Normally, people wouldn't want to visit caves, but this one is one of the most interesting caves in the world. The Lascaux Cave is a treasure trove for archaeologists around the globe. The cave complex contains prehistoric paintings that are 17,300 years old. Yes, you heard that right. The series of Paleolithic paintings that look hauntingly vivid hug the walls and depict animals like cattle, stags, bison, and many more. Sadly, the cave is closed to the general public since 1963. Archaeologists believe that human presence might destroy the ancient works of art. Number 7. Area 51. It is the one place most readers are likely to expect to see. Area 51 is a nickname for a military base that's located in the southern portion of Nevada in the western United States, close to Las Vegas. Situated at its center is a large, secretive military airfield. The base's primary purpose is to support the development and testing of experimental aircraft and weapon systems. Area 51 is also always wrapped in conspiracy theories. The intense secrecy surrounding the base has made it the frequent subject of conspiracy theories, which the U.S. government barely acknowledges. The sign above states that deadly force can be used if people enter the Area 51 zone. Conspiracy theorists believe that the officials conceal alien evidence at the base. It's totally off limits to the commoners, and even the USA barely acknowledges the existence of Area 51. Number 6. Valle de Javari. The Javari Valley is an indigenous territory located in Brazil. It occupies more than the whole of Austria, but remains untouched by modern civilization. While several humans are living in the area, they are unaware of the world as it is today. Hence, it's not correct to say that the area is unexplored, but its details are not known to us. The tribes living here are so cut off from modern civilization, they have probably not even seen a wheel. Needless to say, they are also untouched by the world wars and the Industrial Revolution. Around 3,000 indigenous people are currently living in Vale de Javari. Around two-thirds of them are probably unaware of the modern world altogether. We're sure many explorers would have loved to visit this place, but the Brazilian government has banned anyone from entering. They essentially want to preserve the lifestyle of these people, and so only maintain a watch on them from aerial observational methods. Living like these tribes live may be quite tempting for the private ones among us. In a world of constant connectivity, social media, and extreme unrest, going back to the basics seems like bliss. For now, however, we have to make do with documentaries and speculations about how these people live. Number 5. Yucatan Cenotes. The Yucatan Cenotes are a large cave network located in Mexico. A cenote is a particular type of cave that's formed when limestone bedrock collapses. Parts of the Yucatan Cenotes are underwater, which creates additional problems for potential cave explorers. Even fish seem to know that underwater caves are bad news, since they're often left alone, even by marine life. If the whole idea of an underground cave that nobody has ever been in isn't spooky enough, ancient Mayans used cenotes just like the ones at the Yucatan for sacrificial offerings. Maybe we should just leave these places alone. Number 4. Svalbard Global Seed Vault. The Doomsday Vault is a seed bank situated in the middle of the Arctic. Seeds from every place in the world are sent to the Doomsday Vault for long-term storage. The vault is only open to special guests on specific days. The vault is hidden away deep inside a mountain on a remote island in Svalbard. The vault has different types of plant seeds. It's an attempt to safeguard the seeds. The vault holds 10,000 varieties of essential food crops and more than 4,000 plant species. It's a long-term seed storage facility that was built to withstand the effects of man-made and natural disasters like the ones going on these days. The purpose of the vault is to store duplicates of seeds from the world's crop collections. If nuclear war or global warming were to kill crops, nations could request seeds from the vault to restart their agricultural processes. In 2018, the Norwegian government proposed to allocate 100 million Arctic currency, which is around 12.7 million, to upgrade the seed vault to help safeguard the genetic material it contains. Number 3. Surtsey Island, Iceland. Surtsey is a volcanic island off the southern coast of Iceland. The most interesting thing about the island is that it's one of the world's newest islands and was named after the Norse fire god, Surtur. In 1963, it emerged from the Atlantic Ocean after a fiery eruption. Columns of ash were sent into the air almost 9,200 meters. For nearly 4 years after the eruption, the volcanic core built up the island with elevations of around 152 meters. The island is now home to a long-term biological research program to study the colonization process of new land by plant and animal life. It was declared a nature reserve in 1965, and in 2008, UNESCO declared it a World Heritage Site. Surtsey is restricted to the public and is still only open to a handful of scientists who study the island. And with that, it's now time for today's subscriber pick. Today's photo was sent to us by a subscriber. If you come across a photo online and want to know more details about it, just send it over to us. We might even feature it on a future video. Number 2. This place is probably in Amazon, as the rainforest suggests that. Amazon rainforest is the biggest forest in the world and also home to millions of species that have been undiscovered. As many countries have now used it for cattle farming, a huge chunk of the forest has now been wasted, but there are still parts that are very much undiscovered, and some communities even reside inside. Number 1. Antarctica. You can visit Antarctica, but it is fairly complicated. There are guidelines for the visitors to follow, and oh boy, if you break those guidelines, you could be in so much trouble. Each rule broken by a visitor can cause up to a $1,000 fine. It could also lead to 1 year in prison for each rule broken. So, if you've broken more than one, well, good luck with your trip behind bars. Some of the rules there include that you have to clean your boots before landing to avoid bringing foreign species. And that's including some microbes, too. So it's usually done with disinfectant on a cruise ship. If you're on your own, for example, sailing there, you are responsible for following the guidelines themselves. Also, don't disturb wildlife. You can't use guns or explosives and have to avoid protected areas. All of this is because they want to protect the wildlife of the continent. According to the Antarctic Treaty, yes, there is a treaty in place, anybody who's subjected to a crime